You're watching Proactive London. Roquefort Investments listed on the LSE in March, raising £1 million to acquire businesses focused on early stage opportunities in the medical biotechnology sector. Joining me with more on the company and the investment case is Steve West. He's executive chairman and co-founder. Steve, it's good to speak with you today.
Thanks, Stephen. Pleasure to be here.
So Steve, tell us more, what's your strategy and how do you intend to create shareholder value with this strategy?
Yeah, sure. So you kind of touched upon our strategy already. So we're focused on acquiring businesses in the medical biotech sector, and particularly we're looking for early stage opportunities. That's what we're focused on. Now, there's a couple of reasons why we decide to choose the biotech sector. One is there's lots of opportunities in the sector. We see a lot of very good opportunities coming across our desk. And secondly, as a sector, it's probably one of the best performing sectors in the equity market in the last 10 years or so. So we see it as a very exciting sector to be involved in. And I think, you know, more recently as well, there's a halo effect of COVID-19 over the sector as well, which has made it even more attractive as an investment opportunity. So because of those reasons, we are focused on the medical biotech sector. We're looking to leverage off the significant experience that we have at board level. We have a board that has a lot of experience in identifying suitable deals and delivering these deals for the benefit of shareholders. And so we're confident we'll find a target that makes sense from a science point of view, a business point of view, and a capital markets point of view.
Steve, what do you look for when you assess acquisition targets, and how has this process progressed since your IPO back in March?
That's a good question, Stephen. Thanks. So we like to think we take a similar approach to a private equity firm, where we seek out, I guess, unloved established businesses that have already had significant attention and funds invested within the business. But for various reasons, which, you know, for example, could be it's a business unit within a larger company, which isn't getting the focus it should get because there's other businesses within that company, or it could just be lack of commercial know-how within a business. You know, the current owners are unable to take the business to the next level and commercialize it. So we see a few of those around in the market. So that's what we're focused on. But then when we see these opportunities, there's three things that we'll look at. The first one is the value proposition. So the opportunity needs to be early enough in the stage of the development cycle in the biotech sector to have significant unrealized value. So I guess this predominantly points us towards businesses that haven't yet completed their preclinical trials, so they're still finishing up or have finished their research cycle and they're moving towards the preclinical trials. That's kind of the businesses we're looking at. And then another key point for us is risk. So we're looking at businesses that have multiple commercialization options. We don't want a business that just has one outcome, one binary outcome, because from a risk point of view, that can be a disaster. But also, because we're a listed company, we see businesses that have multiple commercialization options, we can see them delivering a lot more news flow, which is very important for us as a listed company as well. So that's a key point for us. And then thirdly, the third thing we look at, which is very important, is the management of that business, which is an obvious one to look at. But we need to be confident there's world-class leading scientists involved in the business, or there's collaborations with such like scientists. So that's the third most important thing for us when we're looking at opportunities. Now, in terms of progress, so we were, as you said, we listed in March this year, so it's been 6 months or so now. We've screened lots of opportunities. There's no shortage of them out there in the market. But I'm pleased to say we have narrowed it down to a few very exciting candidates, which we feel, I mean, any one of these would add significant value to Roquefort. So we're in the process of, deciding which one to take forward at the moment and finalising our due diligence on those opportunities before we make that decision. I think we'll be announcing something on that in the near term, I think. Hopefully, that's the objective anyway.
Okay, so take us through the process and the estimated timing of completing a transaction such as the one you're discussing once you've identified that best target.
Okay. Yes. Again, that's a good question that I guess our investors would really like to know the answer to. So we listed in March as a cash shell, and because we're classified as a cash shell, when we do a transaction, that's going to trigger what's called a reverse takeover process or RTO process under the listing rules. Now, as part of this process, this RTO process will be required to issue a prospectus for the large business, so our business combines with the business that we're buying. And this may lead to a short suspension of our shares while we finalise that prospectus with the FCA, which oversees the prospectus. However, if we are suspended, we see the suspension being for a matter of weeks, not a matter of months. So it's going to be a very short time period. And the reason I can say that is we're very focused on that. That's one of our main objectives in doing a deal. And we look at structuring deals and prioritizing parts of deals to make sure that suspension is minimized. There's a few other reasons why we're confident we can minimize suspension. You know, one is we've only just completed the IPO process, so we can resurrect a lot of work around there. We have very experienced advisors, both legal and brokers, that we work with on a day-to-day basis. So they're up to speed with what we're doing. So we're confident we can utilize their expertise to get this across the line very quickly. And as I said earlier, we have a very experienced board that's done lots of transactions with listed companies in the past. So we know what we're doing, and we're going to make sure that any suspension is absolutely minimized and we can get the transaction completed and done very quickly back on the board and get news flow happening and deliver value for our shareholders.
Of course, you raised funds in your IPO, but going forward, how do you intend to fund acquisitions that you make?
Yeah, no, so that's a very common question for a shell like ours. So we raised £1 million when we listed in March. So it's a modest amount of money. You certainly wouldn't think you'd use all of that would be enough to fund an acquisition entirely. So what we're looking to do is fund an acquisition through a mixture of shares and cash. But what I need to really highlight here is we are very focused on dilution. We're large shareholders ourselves in the board. So we need to make sure that we progress the right size deals that are not too dilutive. And it goes without saying, we'll try and do any share issues at the highest possible price that we can. Now, I guess another way of ensuring that we minimize dilution up front is we'll structure any payments, if we can, to sellers around success as well. So there will be minimal upfront payments, and we'll try and back-end payments around success that are only paid if things work out. So that way we can balance the risk in our favour, and we can also minimise dilution for our shareholders as well.
Mm. Steve, so give us the investment case. Why should investors invest in Roquefort shares now?
Okay, so I guess I'm slightly biased in my answer here, but I think there's a number of good reasons why Roquefort is a good investment. I think the first one to look at is our capital structure. We have a very tight capital structure. We're very picky in who we invited into our IPO in March this year. We have long-term sophisticated investors involved in our company, and they're there to support us, build the business. So that's very important. Very tight capital structure that's committed to us as a board to deliver what we said we're going to do. In terms of the management team, I mentioned it a couple of times, and people are very welcome to look at our website and look at our biographies of the board members. But we have significant experience in delivering value accretive deals for shareholders within listed entities over probably 20, 30 years between us. So of doing such deals. So we know what we're doing, and we're very confident we'll deliver the right deal for our shareholders where we can significantly increase the value of the company and build a proper business. And then I think thirdly as well, it's the sector that we've chosen. I mean, the biotech sector is a very exciting sector to be involved in. It's very fast moving. COVID-19 is a terrible situation that we're going through with that obviously at the moment. But what that has done is it has increased investor focus on the biotech sector. So from an equity markets point of view, it's absolutely the right sector for us to focus on, I think. And in addition, from a business point of view, when we do acquire a business, COVID-19 is actually, there's a few positives that have come out of it. And one of the positives is that it has significantly reduced regulatory hurdles around drug development and delivering those drugs into the market. So we can leverage off that to make sure that we can deliver drugs a lot quicker upon success of an acquisition. We can deliver drugs upon a lot quicker and a lot tighter timelines than what's been done in the past. And then another important point as well, which I think is worth mentioning, is there's been some very big leaps and bounds in drug development technology as well. And I'm sure everyone's heard of the mRNA technology associated with Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. So because of mRNA, this technology that's fairly recently evolved, that leads to a significantly reduced cost of developing drugs, and it brings drugs to market a lot quicker as well. So we can leverage off that as well. So I think in terms of the biotech sector, we think it's the right place to be. It's the right time to be in the sector. And we're very excited to be involved with it. And we're very confident we'll find the right opportunity within that sector for everyone.
And I hope you keep us abreast as you do find those opportunities. Steve, it's been great speaking to you today.
Thanks, Stephen. Thanks for your time.
That's Steve West. He's Executive Chairman and Co-Founder of Roquefort Investments.